Screen real estate on devices is pretty scarce, and material design encourages apps to have a simpler and cleaner look, but this can make it difficult for users to discover all of the options your app offers. I'm Joanna Smith, and this is exactly why you should consider a navigation drawer. A navigation drawer is a panel of options on the left edge of the screen. Usually it is hidden from view, but it can be revealed when the user swipes from the left. It may also be permanently visible if there's enough screen real estate, such as a tablet in landscape mode. Having a navigation drawer, commonly referred to as the left nav, allows your app to offer a wealth of features and behaviors without being visually overwhelming. So you get to keep your most important features front and center, and then when a user is looking for more, they can open this menu. By now, you're completely convinced that you need to build a left nav right away. So allow me to show you what to do. First, you're going to create a drawer layout. The drawer layout should be the root view and contain two child views. The first child must be the view for the main content of the screen. This is for when your left nav is hidden, so that when the drawer is later opened, it will be on top. The second child is the view for the navigation drawer itself. After you've got your layout, you'll need the list of items that will fill it. A navigation view makes this easy by providing the framework you need for the navigation drawer. You just need to provide the navigation view widget with two things: the header layout, if you have one, and the menu of list items. The menu is actually pretty great since it allows you to inflate your content from a menu XML resource instead of managing a list view programmatically. And even better, this means that you get all of your material design styling on the nav drawer for free. This menu resource can be as simple as a collection of checkable menu items. Whichever is currently checked will be displayed as the highlighted nav item. However, you can also build more complex menus by using subheaders to group items together. Now that you have your list of navigation items, you'll need to respond to click events. You'll get callbacks on selected items by setting an on navigation item selected listener using set navigation item selected listener. This callback provides you with the menu item that was clicked, allowing you to handle selection events, change the check status, load new content, and so on. Now, if your navigation drawer is not a permanent view in your app, which is highly likely, you'll want to listen for open and close events. This will allow you to make any adjustments you need before switching views. The default trigger for opening the navigation drawer is a swipe from the left, but you can also use the hamburger icon to toggle the drawer open and closed. Now there's one final note. I've been referring to the navigation drawer as a left nav, but that does not mean it must always be on the left. If your app supports right to left layouts, for example, and you've already marked your layouts with start and end attributes instead of left and right ones, the system will create a right nav for you instead. This way, your RTL users can swipe from the right to open the navigation drawer, and it will be properly aligned on the right side of the screen. So to learn more about Android Dev and to make sure that your app is at its best, check out the rest of our Android Development Patterns content and consider joining the G+ community for tips, tricks, and help. But most importantly, just continue to build better apps.